Stop. Don't do any more rookie premiere sets in Madden 23 or else you don't want to know what's going to happen to you. Let me relax, man. I don't know why I'm making this sound so intense. We're talking about Madden at the end of the day, but in today's video, we'll be talking about why I'm not doing any more sets and why you shouldn't either. Now, salsa to family and welcome back to another Madden 23 video. In this one, like you guys probably can tell by the intro, we're talking about rookie premieres and we're actually talking about why you shouldn't be doing sets right now. Now, if you watched my video from a couple days ago, I did talk about this a little bit, but I want to go in depth onto this topic in today's video because there's a couple important things you need to know about rookie premieres and ultimately why you shouldn't do them yet. Now fellas, the number one reason why you shouldn't necessarily be doing rookie premiere sets right now in Madden 23 is because we don't have enough information about how these cards are going to work come Madden 24. Now if you didn't know, the way rookie premieres work is they're basically a way of building out your Madden 24 team while you're still on Madden 23. So say I do this J Ward set right here, I complete this 99 overall set, basically what I'm going to get is I'm going to get this card in Madden 24, but we don't necessarily know what the overall of the card's gonna be, and we don't know what format EA Sports is gonna use for these players. Let me explain what I mean, because that'll kind of depict why you shouldn't necessarily be completing these sets quite yet. Okay, now as you guys can see in the description for this set, it says you will get a version of the player in Madden 24. They actually just say M24. The intern was too lazy to write out Madden right there, but it says you'll get a version of the player in Madden 24, and that's all we really know. EA Sports has yet to talk about this in any capacity on Twitter, on Twitch. They haven't told us anything about what the overall of these cards are going to be or how the rookie premieres will work. Because there's two different options for the way EA Sports could do rookie premieres. Option number one is they make them like 84, 85, 86 overall players. And if I did J Ward, well, then I would just get the 85 overall version of J Ward in Madden 24. That's option number one. But option number two is they use the upgradable rookie premiere system, which they've done in the past. Now, the way this works is simple. Basically, if I have the J Ward rookie premiere, his cards overall will be the same as his highest overall player in Madden. So say he starts off as like a 70 overall, the rookie premiere would then be a 70. Then if he maybe gets a card in the ultimate kickoff promo or in one of the promos in Madden, the rookie premiere would increase and the stats would be the same as his highest overall player. Then if he got upgraded again, his stats would go up even more. And if you guys can't tell, those are two very different types of players. The first one is just a regular card that stays the same. The second one is someone who's going to go up in overall. And if the second option is used by EA Sports, well, that really changes your strategy when it comes to rookie premieres, because when I complete these sets, what I'm going to be thinking is I'm not only going to be thinking, okay, what player can help me in Madden 24 because they've got good stats, but I'm also going to be thinking what player is going to get upgrades in Madden 24, what player is going to have a good season in the NFL or as a big name and is going to get upgrades. And the fact that EA Sports has yet to tell us any of this stuff is pretty crazy to me. Now, when you guys consider the fact that each rookie premiere set is costing you about 400,000 coins or 450k, for a lot of people watching this video, you probably get like 3 to 10 sets completed, and it's important that you guys make the right decision when you're doing these sets. So for me personally, I am going to be waiting. I am not doing these sets quite yet because, of course, I don't know the way the cards work. Once we know the way the cards work, then we can make decisions on sets. And reason number two why I'm not doing these sets quite yet is because we don't even have all the players in the game yet. We only have the first two releases. There are more releases coming soon. As you guys can see right here, I believe we're halfway through when it comes to rookie premieres. I believe they've released half the players. There's another batch and then another batch after that coming as well. So me personally, I'm just gonna wait until all the cards are in the game, until we have all of our information, and then I'll probably make a video telling you the best players to pick. That's gonna be coming in about 2 weeks. So in about 2 weeks, we'll have all the players in the game. I would suspect we'll have all the information by then as well. And then we'll start to do sets. Because as you guys can see, these sets expire on August 10th. At the time I'm recording this video, that is basically a month away. So we still have a month before we have to make these decisions. We're not necessarily in a major rush. But of course, what you guys can do is you can actually start to build these sets out now if you wanted to. And that's actually something I'm doing. So as you guys can see in my binder right here, I'm starting to collect 98 overall players because I can just use these cards in the sets when they come out. We know that with every single rookie premiere set, the way they're going to do it is simple. You need 298 overall Red Zone Royale players. So what you can do right now if you want to is go through, start to complete some of these sets, start to snipe some of these players. In my opinion, my favorite set is this one right here. It's the 98 overall Red Zone Royale player fantasy pack set. You put in some 95s and then you put in a 93 overall player. So what you can do if you want to is start to snipe on these filters. Like if you want to try and find these 93s at a good deal, if you want to try and find these 95s at a good price, there's no reason to not snipe in my opinion. I think it's actually worth it to go through, try and pick up some of these players. If you're opening up packs and you pull a rookie premiere, just hold on to the card because for the time being, we're not using them, but in the future, we are going to be using them. Of course, we're going to probably empty out our entire bankroll on Madden 23 on Rookie Premieres. That's what I'm going to be doing, at least. So yeah, if you try these packs, if you're opening other packs in this game and pulling Rookie Premieres, or sorry, pulling Red Zone Royale cards, be sure to save those cards because eventually they will have value to you. You will be using them. I'll try a couple packs right here in the background. These packs were solid not too long ago. Not sure how good they are right now when it comes to like getting decent value for your players, but I hope you guys do understand why we're not doing sets right now. I hope I was clear in my description. We're basically waiting for two things. We're waiting, first of all, to hear how Rookie Premieres work in Madden 24. Of course, I'll make a full video talking about that when EA Sports gives us all that info, when we know whether it's just like a regular player or an upgradable player. That's very important information. And then, of course, the other thing that we need to know as we pull a 93 Brian Dawkins, that's pretty good. But the other thing we need to know is we need to see all the cards. We need to have all of our options. Because let's say, for example, in the final release of Rookie Premieres, EA Sports goes crazy. They drop like a ton of really, really good players, but you've already spent all your coins to do Rookie Premier sets for before. Well, then you're kind of screwed over because you don't have the coins to do new sets. So to me personally, I don't see any reason why you shouldn't be waiting unless you're like not able to get on Madden in the start of August. I mean, I guess if you're in that situation, then you can do the sets right now. But assuming you guys will be able to play Madden in August and you will be able to just put some of your 98s into the sets and just make some selections, then I think you should wait. I think there is zero reason not to wait unless you have the coins to be able to complete every single Rookie Premier set and you're like, you know what, I'm gonna do them all right now and then I'll just do more when they come out later. I guess you can do that, but if you're not in that situation, which I'm gonna assume the majority of the people watching this video are in, I'm gonna assume the majority of people watching this video don't have over 10 million coins. And if you don't have over 10 million coins, I don't think you're gonna be able to do all the Rookie Premier sets, as no way we pull a common strategy item. At least it's the Saints. I mean, I guess that gives me a little bit of happiness seeing that logo, but no, I actually don't. 1,000 coins, that sucks. And also, boys, I'm curious, let me know in the comment section how many Rookie Premier sets you're hoping to get completed. I think I should be able to get around 15 of them done, because as I do the sets, I'll be like selling off the starters or like selling off the players on my team. So if we do a set for like a wide receiver, we'll just sell off one of my starting receivers. Same thing with really any position on the squad that has an auctionable player. So I think that should be able to help us out as we get a gold strategy card. That's actually a pretty good pull. I will spend those 110k coins on Rookie Premier packs because why not open up a couple more right here. But yeah, curious how many you guys are hoping to get done. Curious if you guys have already like pre-bought all your 98s or you're kind of just waiting. For me personally, I'm hoping I can continue to get a little bit of free content in this game, which will help me build out some of the sets. Like as you guys can see right here, I think I have a couple 93 plus Rookie Premier packs. We'll open those up because those are like kind of associated with this video. But ultimately, the main point of this is just to make sure you guys are not going through and like wasting your coins and wasting your value by doing sets right now. You should be patient. You should be waiting. Two 93 plus packs before we go. Let's pull a 95 plus right here. To 93 Anthony Rush. I mean, these cards do help us. They're still actually going to help us build out some of the 98s. Final card of the video. We pulled a lot of 93s today. If you guys want to check out how to get a Rookie Premier for free, click right here. I think you can get a couple actually, and I'm out. Peace.